to have the jury, Mr. Pahima is present along with the attorneys of record. Mr. Pahima, I want to remind you, you're still under oath. And with that, Mr. Brown, you may continue with your cross-examination of this witness.
Thank you. Mr. Pahima, I want to take you back to the cornfield where Mollie Tibbetts was put in the corn, okay? You, just to make, I know we've had a lunch break here, but you claim that there were two other men with you at the cornfield. Is that right?
Correct.
And while these men were there, they remained covered, as you've mentioned. Is that correct?
Yes.
So they still had these stocking hats over their faces. Is that right?
Correct.
Still had a long sleeve sweater or that they were wearing. Is that right?
Correct.
And long pants, correct?
Correct.
These two men that you claim were with you at the cornfield, they did not strike you or punch you. Is that right?
No.
No, they did not.
They did not cut you with a knife?
Nope.
No.
They did not shoot you with a gun, correct?
Nope.
No.
They did not even threaten you with a gun. Is that correct?
Sometimes they were pointed, but nothing really serious.
You cannot tell us who these men are, correct?
No.
No.
They left you with your phone, is that correct?
The phone was in the trunk.
I understand that, but did they take your phone away at some point?
The entire time, I did not have it.
But that's my point, is they left your phone with you in your trunk, correct?
Correct.
Which you then had access to, correct?
Correct.
Which means you could have called or texted people, correct?
Correct.
Other than these two men that you claim were at the cornfield with you, you were the only other person at the cornfield, correct?
Yes.
The time that they came to your trailer, did you put that between 6 and 6:30?
I could not tell you with exactitude what the time was. It was between 6 and 7.
What time did you get off work on July 18th of 2018?
Around 5:30.
And you would have gone directly home?
Yes.
And then you took a shower whenever you got home?
No, I went to Brooklyn. Okay.
At some point you took a shower, is that correct?
Correct.
And maybe I had the time wrong, but was that after you had gone to Brooklyn?
Yes.
And it was after you came out of your shower that these two men were, you claim these two men were present in your trailer?
Correct.
That's all I have. Thank you.
Ms. Freeze, any redirect?
Yes, just briefly. Sir, you've listened to Officer Romero describe the interview that took place, is that right?
Yes.
Would you agree with Officer Romero that there are different ways in different parts of Mexico that things are translated?
Yes.
So people use different terms depending on what area they are from.
Yes.
There are parts of Officer Romero's testimony that you don't agree with, is that right?
Correct.
Bottom line, you agree that you lied to investigators that night?
Yes.
Do you recall the part of the interview, or you, excuse me, strike that. Do you recall Officer Romero's testimony where she said that you described Mollie Tibbetts as hot?
Yes.
That was one portion that you specifically took issue with, is that right?
Correct.
And what did you believe was said about Ms. Tibbetts?
Overruled. The witness may answer if he knows.
Well, the word that I used was good looking, not hot.
And if the interpreter could please say the Spanish term that he used.
Interpreter is not sure what the attorney is asking the interpreter to do.
Why don't I do this? The Spanish term that was used was guapa. Is that right?
Correct.
Ms. Freeze, you better spell that to the...
G-U-A-P-A. And sir, what do you take guapa to mean?
Bonita.
Pretty.
We went through the interview after Officer Romero's testimony, is that right?
Yes.
And the term that you used was guapa, is that right?
He's commenting on the testimony of another witness who testified in English.
Overruled.
Correct.
Now, sir, at a certain point, did the interrogation become confrontational?
Yes.
I'm going to direct your attention to Defendant's Exhibit KK. For identification purposes, could you describe what's portrayed in the picture?
Yo sentado en una esquina y la detective Romero y otros dos tipos.
Well, me sitting in the corner, and then Officer Romero, and then two other guys.
These two other guys, were they present during a portion of the interview?
En algunas.
In some.
At this part of the interview, did they both come in and interrogate you?
Yes.
Did Officer Romero also interrogate you?
Yes.
I'd offer Defendant's Exhibit KK.
I would just object to relevance.
Overruled, and Defendant's Exhibit KK is admitted.
Permission to publish?
Granted.
Now, Mr. Bahena Rivera, we specifically watched this portion earlier this week, is that right?
Correct.
And you were able to rewatch the interrogation process that was used?
Yes.
Some of the interrogation is in English, is that right?
Yes.
Is some of it in Spanish?
Yes.
Describe for the jury what you recall being said to you during that interview.
Pues el la persona que el hombre que está sentado en esa en la silla tomó mi mano y me estaba diciendo que estaba mintiendo y que estaba mintiendo.
Well, the man that is sitting on the chair took my hand and he told me that I was lying. I was lying.
Then there's a man that's standing up behind him. Do you remember him ever talking?
Yes.
What do you remember him saying?
Sustained.
Your Honor, it's not for the truth of the matter asserted.
State's response?
I'm not sure what other reason it would be offered for other than
what is the other reason?
It, for the effect on the listener, Judge, and further, the interrogation, the defendant's admissions have been a key part of the state's case, and for the defendant not to be allowed to present the reason that he made those admissions and his state of mind is simply unfair.
And this picture's not needed for that.
Take the picture down and the objection's overruled. Go ahead and proceed.
What did the man say to you that was standing up?
A word in English, but I don't remember. I don't know how to say it.
Describe his tone of voice.
He was yelling.
No further questions.
Mr. Brown, anything else of this witness?
Yeah, Mr. Bahena, a question. You agree you're the only one who could take the police to the body of Mollie Tibbetts?
Yes.
That's all.
We done with this witness?
Yes. Okay.
Mr. Bahema, you can go ahead and be reseated back over here if you would, please.